again to Jester Bushcraft. Today I'm going to show you my first fire steal attempt using a little fire steal I bought back in the 80s when I was in Cubs or Scouts. I never actually used it properly, so I found it in my shed the other day and I thought I'm going to have to give this a try. It's only a small fire steal, but it creates quite a good spark, but I've never actually tried it for actually making a fire. So I'm just using a bit of cotton wool here as my tinder. I've got a bit of birch bark as well, which I'm going to use. Now, bearing in mind, I've never used this before. This is my first ever attempt, and it quite shocked me when I first struck it. I was quite surprised to see that light up so quickly. It soon got going. I've got it going on a piece of paper there, just so you could see it properly. But as you'll see in a minute, that soon takes hold. So from one quick spark and a bit of cotton wool, I've got a good flame going there to start building a fire. I didn't actually get any firewood to keep it going because I just wanted to try the fire steel out, see how effective it was. And as you can see, it was quite effective. The fire steel was originally one I bought from Survival Aids in Penrith, and it's actually got like a wick surrounding the striker, and the container that the wick's held in is a little reservoir which you put meths in or lighter fuel, and when you strike the steel on the flint, the spark ignites the meth soaked wick and it's like a little permanent match. But the meths always used to leak out, which is why I never ever used it. That worked quite well. I now keep that attached to a little zip pouch, which I keep my cotton wool in, and my birch bark as my little fire starting kit. I'll probably buy a bigger one, but for now, this one should keep me going. So there you go, my first ever fire steal attempt.